Hi, this is the Fiery Joker, and, yeah, I know I said I'd never do a Let's Play, but, well, the thing is that after releasing the top 10 worst Kingdom Hearts bosses, I just felt like, you know, playing a Kingdom Hearts game again. It's like, you know what, I think I might want to let other people in on it too, so here we go. Here's a Let's Play of Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix. Now, I haven't actually beaten this one. I only played a little bit of it, and I also played a little bit at a friend's house. But after being so kindly provided the ROM by, Jerry Pete, I intend to complete this. So, here we go. Let's start, Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix. Kingdom Hearts 2 is definitely my favorite of the Kingdom Hearts games. It really had the best combat out of all of them, and it just flowed so well, and it was just really, really fun.
It's like a far off memory. A far off memory that's like a scattered dream. You gotta line the pieces up. Yours and mine.
And this sentence really has no bearing on the game whatsoever. Oh my gosh. It's like, even nowadays, these visuals are just really, really good. I still have no idea what she's saying. Yeah, I still remember that scene from the original Kingdom Hearts, since just you can never skip those cutscenes. That just really ticked me off. I'm so glad you can do that in the remake. It's like, give Square some credit. It's like their stories may suck, but good heavens, they can really do some animation. Oh, this scene from Kingdom Hearts. It's like, I've memorized this scene from Kingdom Hearts word for word because I died so much to this guy.
That girl has lost her heart. She cannot wake up.
What? You're not Riku? Nah, I'm not gonna do the whole thing, but it's just... Wait, that wasn't in the original scene! Boo, this is horrible! Kingdom Hearts is light! Here's one thing about the bad thing about Japanese animation. It's just a lot of it consists of just characters staring off into the distance. It's kind of boring. I like to make myself believe that planet Earth turns slowly. Oh my gosh, she turned into dust and got boobs. That's weird. Oh my gosh, they lip sync! They must be related or something! I don't know! Love this part. I'm headbanging. Oh my gosh, Donald is actually awesome and useful. That's a first. Oh man, I just love the animation here. Oh, and especially this part. It's just lots of great synchronization here. Yes, throwing your Keyblade. At first I thought throwing your Keyblade was a very bad, fighting tactic, because it's just... It's like, why would you throw your weapon that's pretty much no more than just an oversized axe at a person? You'd have to go retrieve it, but then I remembered, it's like, oh yeah, it's like, it comes back to Sora when he beckons it, so it's like, oh, so, I get it. But wouldn't that, like, destroy your arm if you would actually throw it like that? And to think, and the hand-eye coordination you would need to do that, that's just, ugh. Oh yeah, did anyone see under Sora's hair? Was that like a compression issue or something? Because there's a whole lot of green under it. It was kind of weird. Oh, this scene wasn't in the original thing. And Roxas falls. He's like the love child of all three of them or something. I don't know. It's trying to be symbolic. I don't know what it means. This scene looks very familiar. I wonder where I've heard it before. I don't know yet. It's just, the scene looks so familiar. It's almost like a carbon copy of something, but I just don't know what it is. Oh, Chain of Memories. And here we have the Dark Ocean. I would probably, kind of reminds me of World of Warcraft a little bit. Black Coat.
You have arrived.
Apparently.
I've been to see him. He looks a lot like you.
That was vaguely creepy. Ah! He has no voice! Ah!
Or maybe I'm all there ever was.
Oh gosh, I hate when people are cryptic like that. That's just ugh. It's like you're not being clever, you're just being annoying.
Do you remember your true name?
Kairi!
Sora?
Aw, so close. I'm really tempted to skip the cutscenes, but because I can. But this is just kind of fun to just. It's kind of fun to just comment on these.
Giving up already?
Yeah, for a recap, this actually does a very good job considering it It does a very good job because it just skips it. It just only highlights the important parts and it really doesn't take a lot of time at all. But that's not Ansem's voice. Oh, why'd they change it? There's just so many.
The door.
They just changed so many voice actors throughout the series. In this game. Diz is voiced by Christopher Lloyd. No, not Christopher Lee. Christopher Lee. And in other games, he's not voiced by Christopher Lee. It's like, come on, Christopher Lee, man. Christopher Lee is awesome. He should voice Sumner if there's ever a Gauntlet remake. What teenager would own this sort of crap? This is not the 80s. Kids don't own this stuff anymore.
Another dream about him.
You must be in love with him or something. You know, I've always wondered about Twilight Town. Is this a town that's locked in a perpetual twilight? So it's always dusk and dawn or something? I've always wondered about that because it's, you know, just... Could a civilization exist like that? I don't know. Maybe it could, I'm not sure, but... Would you be able to survive? Would you be able to even get to sleep? Because I know I can barely get to sleep when twilight.
Dude, I'm freaking out, man. My hands.
Dawn of the first day.
Cypher's gone too far this time.
I can't do the math because the characters are talking. 7 times 12, that is 70 plus 14, that's 84.
I mean,
so 84 hours
it's
remain.
It's true that stuff's been stolen around town.
If it's a week.
And we've got a score to settle with Cypher and everything. So, if he wants to think we did it, I can't really blame him. See, that's not what really bugs me.
What really bugs you, Hayner?
What really bugs me is that he's going around telling everybody we're the thieves. Now the whole town and their mothers are treating us like the Klepto Club.
Okay, when I first heard that,
ticked off before
I thought it was real.
Because I haven't. Nuh-uh. Never. Now, what to do?
Oh, yes. Just go fight the guy. That'll really clear up your names. Great job. Come on, Roxas, spit it out.
We could find the real thieves. That would set the record straight.
Yep.
Hey, that sounds fun. What about Cypher? First, we gotta clear our names. Once we find the real culprit, everyone will get off our backs.
They're not on your backs
now. They're gone. Are gone.
Your dodos are gone?
What? All our
hobos?
Gone?
You can't save
Logo?
Why not?
But you do understand what I'm saying, right? Our
Frollo
are gone. Stolen. And not just the
Popo.
The word.
Coco.
They stole it too. What kind of thief is that?
I cannot believe I just did that.
Never have pulled that off.
No, really?
Alright, time for some recon.
Oh yeah, I said recon because I got the camo pants.
Huh?
Freaking out, man!
His heart is returning.
Yeah, I said recon.
Doubtless he'll awaken very soon.
Ooh, so foreboding. Oh yeah, really, great friends. It's like your friend just falls behind you and,
Huh? Roxas, come on.
Yeah, I know they're not real, but still, these are some pretty crappy imitations of friends.
Cut!